Welcome to AETCM, the Emergency Medicine Channel. Today we are discussing how to switch a insulin infusion to regular fixed dose insulin, then to a long-acting insulin regime. You may be knowing many patients who are admitted in ICU for sepsis, heart attack, some surgeries, we are giving continuous infusion. Suppose I am giving continuous infusion for a patient, like 1 unit per hour we can give, 2 units per hour you can give, 3 units per hour you can give. It's all given per hour. So in a day, you have to calculate the maximum dose what you are given. Suppose in a patient who is in ICU, I want to change this patient from ICU to ward. I had given 100 units in the previous day. Today I want to shift this patient to ward. So already 100 units regular insulin infusion was given for this patient yesterday. I want to switch to regular fixed dose, 3 times dose. So what I have to do, you divide this 100 units into 3 different doses. So it may be around 30 units TID, that will become 90 units. From infusion, you can slightly reduce the dose, fixed dose, subcutaneous, because patient is stabilized, his infection has come down, his activity is going to increase in ward. So 90 units, 3 times before food, 15 minutes before food, you have to give a regular insulin, which is rapid acting insulin, which was given as an infusion. Now I switch to fixed dose. So I am giving today 30 units, 3 times daily. So in ward, patient is more stabilized, better stabilized, treatment is completed. I want to discharge this patient. This patient is getting 30 units, 3 times, continuously for maybe 3-4 days. Now I have to give long acting insulin for this patient. Long acting insulin, what you must understand is there are different preparation. You have 25/75, 30/70 and 50/50. 25/75 means 25 short acting, 75 long acting. 30/70 means 30 short acting, 70 long acting. 50/50 means 50 short acting, 50 long acting. So as a standard protocol, I am selecting 30/70 insulin for this patient on discharge. The regular insulin was given in 3 times dose. I want to switch this to 2 times dose, and it is a long acting insulin. So when you convert a short acting insulin to long acting insulin, In a normal course, you take 2/3 of the dose which was given in the previous day. So I had given 30 units 3 times daily, 2/3 of this dose may be 60 units. So I have to give 60 units long acting insulin for this patient. If the total dose is more than 40 units, that means in a syringe, insulin syringe, you take 1 ml 40 units only. So if it is more than 40, it is better to split this dose. So my patient was given 90 units per day with a regular insulin. I reduced it to 60 units when I wanted to give a long acting insulin. In that, 2/3 should be in the morning, 1/3 should be in the night. So I have to give 40 units long acting insulin in the morning, or mix acting insulin in the morning, and 20 units in the night. So in ICU, I was giving 100 units. From there, I have reduced to 90 units 3 times daily, fixed dose. I wanted to switch to long-acting or mix-acting insulin. I have to take only 2/3 of the total dose, that is around 60 units. In that 60 units, 2/3 I have given in the morning, that is 40 units, and 1/3 I have given in the night, that is 20 units. So this is how you have to switch the patient from infusion to fixed protocol, from fixed short acting protocol to fixed long acting protocol. So we have discussed how to switch from ICU to ward, ward to home. This is the insulin protocol normally we follow. Thank you.